Welcome to ISU Gen Chem Lab Tutorials. In this lesson, we learn how to use a micropipette. We use micropipettes in the chemistry lab to accurately and precisely deliver a variable volume of liquid. Micropipettes come in a variety of sizes, which differ in their volume ranges. We will commonly use two types. A larger pipette has an adjustable volume range from 1,000 to 5,000 microliters. The smaller pipette has an adjustable volume range from 100 to 1,000 microliters. In spite of the difference in size, the two micropipettes operate in exactly the same way. One of the great advantages of the micropipettes is the ability to adjust the volume you want delivered. This volume is adjusted by rotating the plunger left or right. Before attempting to adjust the volume, it is very important to first unlock the volume locking ring. At this point, you should be able to freely and easily rotate the plunger. If any resistance is encountered, please get the assistance of your lab instructor. Below the plunger is the micropipette shaft, and at the end is a removable and disposable tip. The tip size matches the micropipette size. The tip should fit comfortably on to the bottom of the shaft. To adjust the volume, we first unlock the volume locking ring. The display shows the volume the larger micropipette is currently set at. For this pipette, the black digits represent the whole milliliters, and the red digits represent tenths and hundredths of milliliters. Therefore, the volume is currently set at 3.00 milliliters. Now it is set at 4.00 milliliters. If this is the volume we want, we then lock the volume locking ring and proceed. For the smaller pipette, the black digits on the display represent microliters. Therefore, the volume is currently set at 800 microliters. For the smaller pipette, we follow the same procedure. Unlock the locking ring and adjust the volume by rotating the plunger. Now it is set at 700 microliters. Now it is set at 500 microliters. Now it is set at 440 microliters. Finally, we set it at 376 microliters. If this is the volume we want, we then lock the volume locking ring and continue. The plunger has three positions. The resting position, when it is fully extended, the first stop is about 3/4 of the way pushed down, and the second stop when pushed all the way down. Proper technique involves knowing which position the plunger should be at and when. Now we're ready to pipette. Hold the pipette vertically above your liquid, press the plunger end to the first stop, and place the end of the tip just below the surface of the liquid. Slowly release the plunger to draw the liquid into the tip and dispense it into the waste container. We'll pre-wet the tip at least 3 times for best results. Be aware that a common mistake is drawing the tip out of the liquid before the plunger reaches its rest position. This will draw air into the tip, and if not noticed, will be a source of avoidable experimental error. Dispense the liquid into the waste container and try again. Finally, to deliver the known volume of liquid, push a plunger to the first stop, pause a moment, then to the second stop. When finished with the tip, press the ejector button located at the top of the micropipette to eject the tip into its proper waste receptacle. To illustrate the high precision and accuracy possible with a micropipette, the mass of 0.501 milliliter volumes of room temperature deionized water was measured 20 times. The measurements show a relative standard deviation of less than 0.3% and a negative 1.5% error based upon the density of water. The accuracy of the micropipette may be improved with its periodic recalibration.